Let's not get ahead of ourselves just yet. Having had time to think about it, I find I may or may not have skipped over these steps a time or two. And without drawing too much attention to that fact, let's go over my technique for laying out and cutting the perfect scarf joint. I'm going to break this down a bit, show the process a little differently, and as much as possible, do just that, show the process. I know many of you would like to hear me drone on about this for hours, and I could certainly do that. Let's save that for another day. Today I'm showing the process I use. It's not perfect, but it's perfect enough. If I don't ensure this angle is spot on, when I begin CNC milling the rest of the neck, I will incrementally lose tolerance, and by the end, be left with an ugly, misshapen, and non-functional mass of lumber. It seems simple and easy. It didn't start that way. I have struggled through many difficult and sloppy scarf joints in the past. As always, if you have any questions, I'm more than happy to answer them in the comments below. I'm happy to respond to your cheeky quips, and even happy to rebuff and rebuke the nasty, haphazardly authored snarky critiques. And as always, thanks for watching. Thank you.
tack is holding it so it's not moving at all, and the glue is sliding in. It's squeezing out, so I'm getting the perfect squeeze out, but I'm